Little Michael. I'm still not used to the name, but it's starting to grow on me. He's perfect, and he looks just like you. He's got your eyes. March 1985. He really surprised me this weekend. He blindfolded me and whisked me off in the car. When he took the blindfold off, I saw this horrible little rundown cabin in the woods. He'd purchased this place from an estate sale of a deceased hunter or something. He wants to fix it up so we'll have our own little romantic getaway. Maggie's staying with the neighbors for the weekend, so I guess I'll make the most of it. March 1985. He's like a changed man out here. At first I wasn't sure this place is creepy, but last night was simply amazing. Maybe this was a great idea. It just needs a woman's touch. March 1985. I don't ever want to come back. Last night there were all kinds of strange noises. I could hear whispering. I think maybe some of the locals don't want us here. I heard something in the basement and had to investigate. Oh my god, it's a slaughterhouse down there with some really weird shit going on. I appreciate taxidermy as an art form, but this looked like more than that. In the cabin's unknown history and the strange noises, it'd be a cold day in hell before I'll set foot in here again. This is how those horror movies start. 26. We just got back from the hospital with the latest addition to our family, little Michael, and he's perfect. Feeling a little strange though, almost depressed. I feel so guilty for feeling this way when it should be a time for celebration. Gary's been great, but he doesn't understand how I'm feeling. I tried to talk to him about it, but he just doesn't get it and tells me to be happy. He's right, but it's not that simple. Isn't it normal that I'm having postnatal depression with my second child when I didn't have it with my first? I'm depressed and happy at the same time. My God, this is confusing. I hope it passes. I know Gary will support me through this. I'm sure it's all going to be fine. The nurse suggested that I keep a journal to help work through my thoughts. So, here we go. I'd love to see the bride before the wedding. Get out of here, you. Wait a minute. Come here, you. Now go. We're gonna be late to the altar. Just needs a woman's touch.
Dear Diary, I haven't spoken to Dad in years. We avoid each other as much as possible. He's always drinking and I'm scared to talk to him. Mom is a mess. She's so weak. I hate them both. I hate it here. I'm a prisoner in my own room. I can't have my friends over. I stay at Bridget's house as much as I can. It's time for a change. I met a boy 2 months ago. His name is Carl and I think I love him. I told him about everything yesterday. My dead brother, drunk father, and drugged up mother. I thought he'd run for the hills, but he says he wants to save me. He says we should run away, and I think I will. What is my future here? I can't stay. I feel bad leaving my mom, but if she ever grew a spine, she'd have taken me away from here years ago. I have to go.
their eyes. He's really...
started babbling about this being the place of conception and rummaging through that fucked up basement. I don't know if I should be indulging him or getting help. I want him to get help, but I'm scared of how he reacts. I'm still not used to the name, but it's starting to grow on me. Perfect. And he looks just like me.
Some believe this is their life flashing before their eyes. Every action you take will bring you closer to your judgment.
Gary's gone totally insane.
Maggie ran away.
She hates me for not standing up to him. She cried
out. I'm all alone. And I wish my little girl would come home.
I can't just leave him like this.
I can't just leave him like this.